Hello everyone, welcome to another Adobe Illustrator tutorial. My name is Andre from Dagobi. Today I'm going to show you how to draw birch trees and I'm going to show you how to make brushes and how to draw with brushes. Please create a new document, go to File and click New. So I use 340mm for the width and 210mm for the high, and I use color mode RGB. So first create a big rectangle. And fill this rectangle with a gradient. So non-color for stroke. And apply a gradient. So I use green gradient. And change the type to radial. So make a double click on the second gradient slider. And change this also to dark green. So next choose the gradient tool and move the gradient and scale is very big. So next lock this layer and create a new layer. So next choose the blob brush tool. Make double click on this tool and change the size to 30 points and set the fidelity to that position and click OK. So and draw your birch trees. So but set the fill color to white. So next, we have to create a clipping mask. So choose the rectangle tool and create a big rectangle. So please open this layer 2 and make sure that the rectangle are on top. So next, go and deselect all and now select the group layer and click on this button, make release clipping mask. And I'm going to lock this layer and next choose again the blob brush tool and draw more trees. So if you wish, you can move some of these trees. So choose the group selection tool and move these trees a little bit. So, that's fine. So, please group the trees. Select all trees and now go to Object and click Group and lock this layer. So next you have to create a brush. So choose the ellipse tool and create an oval. So next, select the left point and delete this point. Click on this button, remove selected anchor points. And select the right point and convert this point to corner. Click on this button, convert selected anchor points to corner and move this point a little bit to the left. So that's fine. And now it's very important to change the fill color to black. And now go to the brushes panel, click on this button, new brush, or you can go to the brushes panel options and click new brush. We need an art brush. And now set the colorization method to tints and click OK. So you can delete this shape. So next choose the paintbrush tool and your new brush, and we need white color for the stroke. So I'm going to change the stroke white to 0.5. And going to change or set the fidelity to this center position. So if you wish, you can change the stroke height So if you wish, you can select some of these anchor points, choose the direct selection tool and select some of these points and convert these points to corner. So next group is branches. So select all these new layers and now go to the layers panel options and click on collect a new layer. And move this branches behind the trees. So next I'm going to draw some more lines inside this branches layer. So I use the same brush and to zoom in. So next I'm going to create some simple shapes for the dark strokes of this birch, and I do that inside the tree group. So this time choose a pencil tool, make a double click on this tool and set the fidelity to the center position. And create some shapes. So change the color to black color for fill and none color for stroke. So next I'm going to convert this shape to brushes, these four shapes. So we need scatter brushes. So you can drag these shapes into the brushes panel and check the scatter brush, click OK and set all this to random and set the rotation relative to page and set the position method to tints and click OK. Make the same with the other brushes. So next, choose a paintbrush tool and create a line. So I use this first brush. Now make a double click on this brush and change the settings. And make the same with the other brushes. So next, please delete all these black shapes. Oh, sorry. So I start with the trees. So it's very important to create a clipping mask of these trees. Select the whole group, click on this little circle, and now go to object and create first a compound path. So next, duplicate this compound path and group both layers. And convert this first layer to a clipping mask. So deselect all, select only this trees layer and click on this button, make release clipping mask. So next, choose the paintbrush tool and one of these new brushes, set the stroke color to black and create a line. So it's very important to draw these lines inside the trees group. So move this new path into the trees group. So please use all brushes. So if you wish, you can change the stroke width some of these brushes. So select some lines or you can delete some lines. So make the same with the branch group. So this time, before I convert these shapes to a compound path, I'm going to expand the branches, select the whole group, go to object and click on expand appearance. And now open the pathfinder and click on this button, unite. So next, go to Objects, Compound Path, and click on Make. So next, duplicate this layer. And now deselect all. Select the group layer and click on this button, make release clipping mask. So I'm going to use the same scatter brushes, but I'm going to change one of these options. So first, select all four brushes and make a copy of these brushes. So drag these four brushes down to the new brush button. And now make a double click on this brush and set only the rotation relative to path. So next, choose a paintbrush tool, choose black color for stroke, and I'm going to try these brushes. Oh, sorry. You have to change the second option, so make again a double click and change the rotation to fixed and set 90°. And change the stroke width to very small. So that's fine. And make the same with the other three brushes. So if you wish, you can change the black color to dark gray. So please unlock all. And now choose the magic wand tool. Open magic wand tool panel and enable the stroke color and click on this black strokes and change this to dark gray. So that's fine. So next I'm going to create a new brush. So please lock all groups and create a new layer. Choose the rectangle, the ellipse tool, and create an ellipse like this. Change the color, non-color for stroke and black color for fill. Choose the direct selection tool and select only these two points and move these points a little bit down. So next, select only this point and change this point, convert this point to corner. Click on this button, convert selected anchor points to corner. So next, choose the add anchor point tool. Zoom in and add two points. And with the direct selection tool, select the center point and move this down. Hold down shift. So hold down Alt to drag this handle. So next, select these two points and now cut this shape. Click on this button, cut path at selected anchor points. And now we have two shapes. So next, select the right shape and change the fill color to gray. Next, choose the direct selection tool and select this shape. And now select these two points. Go to Object, Path, and choose Join. And make the same with the left shape. So next, rotate. Select both shapes and rotate this to 90 degrees. Hold down shift. So if you wish, you can change this gray color, make this a little bit darker. So that's fine. Select both shapes and create a brush. So this time we need an art brush. Set the brush scale options to scale proportionately and change the colorization method to tints. And we need a second brush, a scatter brush. So rotate this to 90 degrees. And change all the other three to random. Click OK. So choose a paintbrush tool and create a line. So first change the color make a double click. Set the colorization method to tints and rotate this to minus 90 degrees. That's fine. So open the options and now change the settings. So that's fine. So delete this line and this shape. Choose paintbrush tool and I start with the art brush with orange color. Change the color to red. And now use the scatter brush. Change the size to 2 points. And we need a clipping mask. So choose a rectangle tool and create a big rectangle. Deselect all and create a clipping mask. Choose again the paintbrush tool and change the color So next, choose again the art brush. So next I'm going to change the color of my background. So select this layer and now go to edit, edit colors and choose recolor artwork. Enable edit and click on this button, link harmony colors and change this little bit to blue and so that's fine. So if you wish, you can change the dark color a little bit. So that's fine. And now last I'm going to draw some big leaves with my art brush. So I use orange color. Oh, sorry. Change the stroke color. Orange or red. Thanks for watching. If you liked this tutorial, please press thumbs up and share it with your friends. If you want to see more of my tutorials, please subscribe my channel. Hope to see you soon.